All right, today I want to look at a website I've been using now for really quite a long time. This company is called Blurb, and what they do is print books. They are one of the companies driving technology behind the self-publishing revolution that's happened in the last 5 and 8 years. As it happens, they found me in 2013, so now we have a slightly more formal relationship, but I've been using this site since, I think, 2008 or something like that, so for quite a long time. And I do all of my paperbacks and hardcovers through this system. So what Blurb has done is make the process of making books very, very simple. Let's start by looking at the sorts of books you can make here. Certainly, you can make photo books, which is what you can now do in a lot of different places. So you can do this through Apple, you can do this through, you know, there's loads of companies now who have made the margins in this business vanish. So photo books, certainly you can do. But the part that I'm interested in that's unusual about Blurb are the trade books. These are the kinds of books that you find in bookstores. These are pocket-sized books, trade paperbacks, hardcovers as well, in the world of publishing your own book. And this is where I think Blurb really comes into its own. So let's say for a second that I want to create a book, maybe one of my books. I'll show you here. This is timlevy.net. You can see I have a number of books. Here's one called Creativity and Innovation, for example, which is published via Blurb. And I happen to know it's about 120 pages. So if I go back to the Blurb website and I type here in to calculate the price of 120 pages, and let's say I want 100 copies, then I calculate the price and kaboom, it tells me that I would get 100 copies of the trade paperback, which is the one I'm interested in black and white, which is what I'm interested in, for $599. So it's about $6 a pop. If we just take it down to one copy, obviously the price is going to go up. There you are, $8 a pop. So I can get myself my own book uploaded to this website, even a single copy, for as little as, in this case, $8. So let's look at how to do that a little bit more specifically. Well, firstly, what's happened is Blurb has come up with a variety of different ways of doing this. The easiest, I think, is what they call BookSmart. So BookSmart is where, and we're going to do this in a moment, where you download an app to your computer and create the computer using the app, and then upload it to the Blurb system, who will then print it out for you and send it to you. The other thing that I use a lot is the InDesign plugins. Now, I'm not expecting you to know how to use InDesign. I'm expecting you to hire someone who knows how to use InDesign from websites like Fiverr and Elance. For example, if we go to Elance, and there is another video on this if you haven't seen it. Also, it's covered in another one of my books called The Entrepreneurial Handbook, which shows you exactly how to use Fiverr and Elance and all of these sorts of tools to build your own global dynamic team. But let's come back here to Elance. If I want to find a designer, I just type in designer. Third time lucky. There we go. And Elance will tell me, in this case, that there are 36,000 and a half designers waiting to help me work on my book. If I type in InDesign, I become even more specific, and now there's 3,362 designers who know InDesign. If I, for example, make it into just the United States by changing this criterion down here, it comes back with a smaller number of people. On and on they go. You can see. And 1,300 people who know how to use InDesign and live within the US. As it happens, this one here, Mary A, is someone I've used many times who's terrifically talented. So that's where I would hire somebody to do the InDesign work you needed if you wanted to have a higher quality design than just the basics. But let's go back to Blurb. So let's say I just wanted to work on my own and create a paperback. How would that? Well, I'd start by downloading BookSmart. To do that, I jump onto their BookSmart page and I click on download now. I believe they like to ask you to create a free account first, just so they can stay in touch with you, which makes sense as well because you need an account to upload to. Now, as it happens, I already have an account with these guys. So I'm going to sign in quickly and here I am at the download Blurb for PC. Of course, you can have it on Mac. There are various different options, but I'm just going to go for PC right now. Click this, save the file, and it's going to pop onto my computer. Let's go to the download directly so we can find that file and run it. There it is, BookSmart. And now it's going to run this app or install this app onto my computer. Now we've got this app installed. So let's run it and see what happens. Well, you need the BookSmart app. Now that's been installed, it pops up like this. In this case, let's start a new book from scratch. And I'm going to use an old manuscript of mine for a book I've written called The Google Gamble. So I just type in the title and my name, and in this case, select a trade paperback, which is the standard size used in bookstores. Now it asks, what kind of layout do I want? Do I want just something blank? I'll go from my own, you know, cognizance, just go from scratch. Do I want to use one of their portfolios, such as a photo book or a guest book? I could even use a blog where I go straight to a blog on the web and it'll draw down the content for me. In this case, I have a Word document, which is how I recommend you begin. So I say I want a Word document, click on continue. It says which Word document. So I click on, because I can have multiple documents, I'll click on get Word document and I'll grab the manuscript from the Google Gamble. When I click on continue, it asks me for a couple of options. How do I want my chapter openers? How do I want my pages to look? Select anything you like. In this case, I'm just going to click continue. And now I'm going to count 1, 2, 3. And in that 3 odd seconds, magically, Blurb actually lays out my book for me. As you can see here in the window, I've got lots of design options up the top. I've got various formats on the left. I've got my book itself here in the middle, and I've got my pages all the way down the bottom. I'm going to change from hardcover to soft cover because I'm going to do a paperback first. I'm going to go ahead and select the view of my whole cover, which I can now see. I'm going to pop in the zoom a little bit so I can see the whole cover. And as you can see, it sort of has a generic cover ready to go for me, which is basically the name of the book and by, you know, in this case, by me. If I pop into some of these inner pages, you can see it's laid out the text for me in a sort of a standard format brought in from my own Word document. I've got lots of options here. For example, if I wanted to change the font on this page, I could do select all, which is control A, and I could change the font from dialogue, which it seems to be, to say Georgia, which now makes it into a nice serif font like that. And I could begin to play with the layout if I wanted to. And you can see there's a title here. It does have a style system. So up here, I could say select style, heading level 1, and it'll pop it into heading level 1. If I select this copy again, and I change it to say body copy, it'll pop it into a body size. Looks like I selected the wrong thing there. Put that one back to heading 1. So there are some basic layout tools that you can use to lay out your book. As I said, this is sort of a basic tool designed to give, in my opinion, sort of more of a draft rather than a complete sort of book. For me to do a complete book, I would hire someone to do the design using a service like Fiverr or Elance, more likely Elance. But you can see here very quickly, I've got a page laid out beautifully, ready to go. And with a small amount of work, you can see the following pages, I could go ahead and change the font, change the spacing, and get my book to where I wanted it. You can see here down the bottom, it's already laid out, in this case, 76 pages. With regard to a cover, you can see this is sort of blank. What I could do here is go to a website like Fiverr or Elance and get a cover done for me. So for example, if I popped over here to Fiverr and type in cover design, you can see that there are thousands, in this case, there you go, nearly 20,000 people who'd love to do a book cover for you, which you can then pop into your Blurb manuscript. Now, once you've got a cover that you like and you've got some copy that you is laid out in the right way, you can press here where it says preview book, and flick through it one last time to make sure it's how you want it. In this case, it's obviously pretty rough for this example. And then you click on here, it says order book. This is where it's amazing. It'll do, you know, all these various spell checking, what have you. But once you've got that done, you simply log into your account on Blurb and it will upload it there for you for free. Let me have a look at some here I've done before. I'm going to sign into my account. I've obviously got quite a few books in here. And here you go. Here's a couple of them, including Creativity and Innovation. So let's have a little look at that book. Well, what's great is when you upload this particular book, it automatically creates a sort of a sales page for you. Let me actually go and find one for the Google Gamble. My Book Projects. Okay, here I am on Blurb. And if I scroll down, here's the page for the Google Gamble. Now, this one I actually did using InDesign and the InDesign plugin. So my Elance designer uploaded this for me, but it has the same kind of result. So let's have a look at the page that Blurb automatically creates for me. In fact, if I click on this link here, view this book, the way it's displayed to other people, I can see that right away. It keeps telling me that because I'm logged in. You can see, firstly, it allows me to preview the book. This is very powerful. And I can select how many pages are previewable. I'm going to go full screen. And you can see there's my cover and into the pages. And these are just scrolling through the pages of my book so that someone could have a little look and make a decision whether they might like to buy that. Again, you can limit this to the number of pages that you wish. Here I am back on the setup page. So in here, I can say whether it's publicly available or not. You can see here, I could have it just available for me or by invitation only. In this case, it's available to the public. I could just show the first 15 pages of my book, or I could select how many pages I want them to show. Let's leave it on 15. I can choose the book language. In this case, it's going to be English. I can see a few things here I hadn't filled in. And I can put some keywords if I want it, for example, business, SEO, or strategy. I can choose my own pricing, which is what's so powerful. I simply select my markup, and there's my final price, $14.99. And then using this link, I can actually pop a promotional little widget into my blog, WordPress, and even onto Facebook. Once I hit save, that page is now live. And as you can see here, back on the page itself, and let's go back to the marketing page itself, this book is now live and on sale. All you do is press add to cart, and whoever comes here is free to check it out, to buy it, I should say, and they would normally have the full price. This is just a price for me because I'm logged in. So that book is now printed and published and on sale and ready to go. And that's why I find Blurb to be such a fantastic and easy to use system. And that's why I love Blurb. As you can see, it's so easy to get your book published and online and on sale and ready to go in a matter of clicks using a free account and free software to do it. And by the way, what's the side benefit? Is when you sell these books, Blurb just sends you a check for the difference between the cost price and the sale price at the end of every month. Not a bad way to get a check at the end of the month, eh?